told JC won't give a damn if that story's in tomorrow, Monday. That woman's as annoying as sin. Smart girl.
I was supposed to be having the time of my life. I was supposed to be the envy of thousands of other college girls just like me over America. But I couldn't get myself to react. I felt very still and very empty, the way the eye of a tornado must feel, moving dully around in the middle of all the surrounding hullabaloo.
Have you ever had an affair with anyone, buddy?
Well, yes, I have.
Tell me about it.
She was a waitress at the hotel I worked at in Cape Cod over the summer.
For how long?
I can't remember. A couple times a week for the rest of summer.
Oh.
Actually, it wasn't the idea of Buddy sleeping with someone that bothered me. What I couldn't stand was Buddy pretending that I was so sexy and he was so pure, and all this time he had been having an affair with that tardy waitress, and he must have felt like laughing in my face.
Esther?
Sorry, yeah,
How would you like to be Mrs. Buddy Willard?
Buddy, I have to tell you something.
You're seeing someone else?
No, it's not like that. I'm never getting married.
You're crazy. You'll change your mind.
No, my mind's been made up.
You see my face in the stars. You don't know me. You write my name on your walls. But you don't know. Scars, but you don't know me. You don't know me at all. I see you down on your knees, but you don't own me. You don't know me at all.
Serena's dissolving, the boys are dissolving, Betsy is dissolving. New York is dissolving, they are all dissolving away, and none of them matter anymore. I don't know them, and I have never known them, and I am very pure. All that liquor and sticky kisses I saw in the dirt that settled on my skin on the way back is turning into something pure.
Friends, JC? Yeah.
Hey.
Is anyone sitting here? Hello. Hi. What's your name? My name's Esther.
My darling dear, love you all the
time. I'm just a fool. Why don't you wear it? It's fun. It's a long game. With you. No, the price worthy of a diamond. The girl should have something just as great in store. For her part of the game. Ouch! You see, I'm quite serious. Let me dance.
I can dance.
Don't worry, you don't have to dance. I'll be dancing.
For you, and I knew the vision of your love, loveliness.
What? Give me back my diamond.
I don't know where it is.
My diamond, give me back my diamond.
I want to go home.
How was New York? Did you enjoy working for Ladies' Day?
I don't want to talk about it.
I didn't hear much from you. Your old mom misses you.
I said I don't want to talk about it.
I'm
So, you say you want more sleeping pills.
Yes.
But the ones I gave you last week are really strong.
They don't work anymore. I can't sleep, I can't eat, I can't read, I can't write. I want to see a mirror.
No.
Why not? Why can't I see a mirror?
Because you don't look too pretty.
Come on, just show me.
Hi, my name is Dr. Nolan.
I'll be your doctor.
Do you mind if I smoke?
No.
So, Dr. Gordon, did you like him?
No.
Interesting. Why?
I didn't like what he did to me.
Did to you?
Electroshock therapy. It hurt.
That was a mistake. It's not supposed to be like that. If it's done properly, it's like going to sleep.
If anyone does that to me, I'll kill myself.
You will have to go through shock therapy here. But if you do, I'll tell you beforehand. And in fact, some people even like it.
Hello? Joan? Joan?
Esler, how nice to see you!
They told me you've been here! What are you doing?
I thought you'd be surprised. Hi!
Hi.
I ran away.
Ran away? What do you mean?
I read about you and I ran away.
What do you mean, you read about me?
I read about you. Here, I have some papers.
What did you do to get yourself in here? In high school, you were so...
I went to the psychiatrist. I wanted to kill myself. When the receptionist was taking me down to my room with my doctor, she turns around and she just asks me, "Oh, do you mind if students can watch you with your doctor?" What was I supposed to say? No, there were 9 eyes. 9, and that's when I left, and that's when I read about you.
So what did you do?
I got all the money I had and I went to New York.
Why New York?
I thought it'd be easier for me to kill myself there.
So, what did you do?
I shoved my wrist through my roommate's window.
Are you okay now?
Yeah, I'm fine. Aren't you?
Come in. There was a mistake. The Nooners forgot to bring my breakfast tray in this morning.
You'll get it later, Miss Greenwood.
You told me that you would tell me.
I am telling you, I came here especially early to tell you.
Why didn't you tell me last night?
If I told you last night, I thought I would keep you awake.
You said that you would tell me!
Esther, listen, I'm coming with you. Everything will be alright. It's okay. I'll be right there with you.
You promise?
I promise.
I like Dr. Noland. I loved her. I'd given her my trust on a platter and told her everything, and she had promised, faithfully, to warn me ahead of time if I'd ever have another shock treatment.
Anytime.
Esther?
Yeah?
It wasn't too bad, was it?
No.
I wouldn't lie to you.
Joan?
Sorry, I just...
I know, the music papers. I never really liked Buddy Miller anyways. He always thought he knew everything. He thought he always knew everything about women.
See what a woman sees in another woman. What does a woman see in a woman that she doesn't see in a man?
Tenderness. Back to the subject that we were talking about. Here's a slip of the doctor that you could talk to, and he can help you out if you need.
Thank you.
Esther? Wow, Esther, it's been forever. Is everything okay?
Yes.
Do you want to come in? Do you want some coffee?
Yes.
Would you mind if I took a call real quick?
Oh yeah, that's fine.
Would it be okay if I spent the night with Joan in Cambridge? Thank you. Joan! Joan! Esther, what's the matter? I'm bleeding, can I have a towel?
Of course.
Yes?
Good morning, Esther. I'm so sorry to bother you this early in the morning. I have some unfortunate news.
What is it?
This morning they found Joan in the woods at the end of our property. One of the orderlies found her.
She's not...
dead, yes. She hanged herself. I'm sorry, Esther.
I have a bill here, Irwin. It's a bill for $20 for emergency attention on a certain date in December for a checkup the week thereafter.
Yes?
The hospital says that they're sending the bill to me because there was no answer to the bill that they sent you.
All right. I'm writing a check now. When am I going to see you?
Do you really want to know?
Very much.
Never.
Don't be scared for your discharge evaluation. I'll be there, and some other doctors will be there, and some visitors will be there too. They'll just ask you a few questions, and then you could go.
I am.